What a beautiful morning. What a big turnout. I did not expect this many people at all. My name is Paul Zwicky. I'm the District 67 Administrator and a Tracy Little League Committee member of this fabulous project. It's my honor and privilege to welcome you to today's groundbreaking ceremony, which celebrates the visible beginning of a new milestone in the journey of Tracy Little League. This is a joyous occasion, especially for the many of us here who have been personally involved in conceptualizing and shaping these baseball fields today. Today we commemorate our groundbreaking for an inspiring and critically needed set of baseball fields. Would you all agree?
Yes.
We celebrate among friends. Friends who share our vision and aspiration for the future of Tracy Little League. Friends who recognize the unique role that Tracy Little League plays in shaping the children in our community. Friends who are leaders within our community who will inspire the next generation and make their own notable contributions as leaders. Friends and donors who have stepped up to expand levels of support to make this dream come true. Like the leaders and builders before us, the project that we are celebrating today has required leadership, foresight, careful planning, and compassion. And while we're just breaking ground today, it's far from the beginning of this project. In fact, this early step has been years in the making. This early step is the first part of the amazing history in caring for Tracy Little League. Each of us today has had a special role in getting these fields to this ceremony. As you know, there's a lot of construction to do and more funds to be raised for this project. In closing, I look forward to standing here with you upon successful completion of this project for opening ceremonies in 2015. I want to extend a special thanks to all of our stakeholders in the group, everybody who's worked hard on the design, and I wish this project a full success. At this time, I'd like to introduce Troop 525 to present our national flag.
Guard attention. For the audience, please rise.
Guard, they're post colors. Blue.
Thank you, Troop 525. Next, I'd like to do the Little League Pledge. The Little League Pledge is all on your programs if you want to follow along with us. I trust in God, I love my country, and will respect its laws. I will play fair and strive to win, but win or lose, I always do my best. Thanks, buddy. Next, I'd like to present to you the 2014-15 Little League President, Mr. Dave Peltz.
Welcome, everyone. I'd like to start by thanking Boy Scouts Troop 525 for coming out this morning and providing the colors for our ceremony. Today, Tracy Little League begins a new chapter with our new home here at Legacy Fields, which is a fitting name because Little League would not be here today without its own legacy. Starting with our founding members who brought Little League to Tracy 25 years ago, our past presidents and board members, sponsors, volunteers, coaches, umpires, parents, and the thousands of boys and girls who wore the Little League patch for Tracy. And last but not least, our 2014-2015 board members and all of the current and future ball players that will leave their mark here at Legacy Fields. I'd also like to thank our mayor, Mr. Brent Ives, our mayor pro tem, Mike Maciel, council members Robert Rickman, Charles Mann, and Nancy Young for coming out today. And a very special thank you to Mr. Ricky Paul, representative for the Honorable Congressman Jeff Denham, and our San Joaquin County Supervisor, Mr. Bob Elliott. I would also like to extend a special welcome to our new city manager, Troy Brown. Welcome, and thank you all for supporting Tracy Little League.
Thank you, Dave. I really appreciate that. At this time, I would like to welcome Mayor Brent Ives to the podium.
Thank you very much. It takes a number of people to make something like this happen. I'd like to first ask for our supervisor, Bob Elliott, to come up and say a few words. Bob?
Well, thank you, Mr. Mayor. I'm very proud and pleased to be here today to participate in this groundbreaking ceremony. It's been a long time coming, and one that that I am proud to say I played a small role in while I was still on the Tracy City Council, when we were involved with the initial negotiations and approval of the agreements between the sports leagues and the city of Tracy to make this entire project happen. So it's a wonderful day to be able to be here and see some ground actually broken. So at this time, I'd like to present this Board of Supervisors Special Certificate of Recognition to Tracy Little League in recognition of the Legacy Fields groundbreaking. The future home of the Tracy Little League at Legacy Fields is a project that demonstrates the possibilities when local government partners with the community. This new facility and the unique partnership between nonprofit leagues and the City of Tracy will have positive impacts on our youth and the community as a whole for years to come. Congratulations on this day of celebration, and thank you to everyone involved in making this possible. Thank you.
Next is my privilege to be able to introduce a representative from Congressman Denham, Ricky Paul. Ricky?
Good morning, everyone. It's truly an honor to be here on behalf of Congressman Jeff Denham. With me, I have a certificate of special congressional recognition presented to Tracy Little League. In recognition of Tracy Little League Legacy Field of groundbreaking ceremony. On behalf of the U.S. House of Representatives, I would like to congratulate you on the Tracy Little League Tracy Little League Legacy Field groundbreaking ceremony. Congratulations and best wishes. Thank you. I apologize for that.
At this point, the Little League has allowed me to say a few words about this project. There are, over the time that you serve a community, just a certain number of things that you'll remember forever. Because I can see myself coming out here for my grandchildren's Little League games from here on out. We knew years and years ago, as Tracy was growing, right at the beginning, that youth sports was going to be an important part of what we did. It was nearly 20 years ago that it became obvious that school sites weren't going to be the final solution for youth sports. It was Tracy Little League that met with me along with a number of other groups back in 1996, and we said, how can we work the long-term systemic issues regarding youth sports fields for Tracy? And this idea of a public-private partnership came out of that meeting and a hundreds of meetings thereafter. There are a few of those people that are here today that actually were with me in that room, and It was fun to catch up and say, wow, look where we are today. But you know, even though we put this money into this ground, and now we put some specifics on how we're going to develop this ground, it was Tracy Little League that took the first step to be able to really get their act together, to be able to put enough money into a pile, to be able to get to this point where they could actually make the public-private partnership work. And I just can't say enough for a group that is that organized, that is that ready. And I know there have been moments where you thought you weren't organized, moments where you thought it was never going to happen. I remember looking at that thing out in the snack shack, drawing for years. But here you are today. And when you ask yourself, I can look back 20 years and when I was coaching and when I was, I don't think it's 20 years ago, but it was a long time ago, when I was coaching and when I was part of Little League, and I said, wow, are we ever going to get to the final solution? Because we knew schools were going to eventually not be there for us. And 20 years from now, your kids are going to be out here continuing and working with their kids. They're going to be building and improving the fields that you're starting today. And it's because you have gotten your act together. You've set the example, not just for yourselves and your future of Tracy Little League, but you've set the example for other youth leagues in Tracy. You've showed them that it can be done. Yes, it's not going to be easy. Yes, it's hard work, but you've got to organize yourselves, and you too can be in this position in a reasonable amount of time. And then you can have control over your own destiny, your own fields, your own schedules, your own way of doing business as a league. So I certainly challenge them today to take the example that Tracy Little League has set for them and make it work. Because you've proven the principle. You, Tracy Little League, have plowed the hard ground of being the first ones in, of being able to make this MOU, this idea of a partnership with the city of Tracy, work. And I know it hasn't been easy. And I look at some of our city staff, Brian McDonald especially, and some others who have worked so hard to try to fix and make it work. And the negotiations have been incredible. But Little League stuck by it. Little League hung in there. Little League are the ones that, like I said, plowed that hard new ground and set the tone for everyone else in town. Naturally, it came with great support from the community. The fundraising efforts have been successful enough to be here to think about not only two, but three fields by April 15th. I cannot wait to come out here and watch that happen and watch that first game. These fields are a symbol of the importance that the city puts on youth sports. You can look around. You're not the only ones that are going to be out here. We put near over $11 million in constructing the infrastructure for these fields. It demonstrates a public-private partnership that really is unprecedented in the state. There's nothing that's going to be exactly like Legacy Fields. And again, it's because of willing partners between a public and a private entity. There are a number of people that are just to be thanked. I mean, you have to know that 30 years ago, Charlie Pikus and his group were thinking the same thing about Jefferson School. How can we build those fields out there? How are we going to make it work? And then 10 years later, how can we get some fields on Monticello? But today, you're building on fields that are in perpetuity. You're going to have these fields. Your kids are going to have them. Your grandkids are going to have them. Congratulations, Tracy. We've done it. We've put something together that's going to outlive us. I just can't help but thank those of you that are on the Little League boards, maybe even past Little League boards, and those of you that are going to be on future Little League boards that are going to get a chance to be able to manage this and make it work to its full potential. And I want to thank the city staffers, and there's too many here to mention. But Troy Brown represents them now. Troy, you should be very proud of the staff that you've inherited that have put so much time and effort into this. I want to thank the council members who've had to make tough decisions, not only this council, but councils years ago that made tough decisions to get to this point to spend this kind of money, to be able to be in this point. I want to thank Parks and Rec commissioners who think about the details of how this all works. I want to thank City Treasurer Ray McCray for keeping track of how things work monetarily for the city, just so we can be in a position to do this. This is a great team effort, maybe one of the greatest team efforts I've seen our city do in my 23 years as being on the council. Again, thank you for allowing me to be part of it. Thank you for what you put into it. It's not over yet, but we're making a great start today. Thank you very much.
Thank you, Mayor Ives. Next, we'd like to move directly to introduce to you Chris Hewitt, our Tracy Little League 2014-2015 Vice President.
Wow, this was more than I had expected. I suppose Ray Liotta said it best, if you build it, they will come. All right? So, again, not to sound repetitive, but thank you everybody for coming. This is a very special event for Little League, for the community as a whole, and for me personally as well. It's been a real long, long journey to get to this day. The desire to build these fields has spanned nearly two decades, four mayors, nearly a dozen council members, and four city managers. It's also spanned the tenure of six Tracy Little League presidents. I would like to take a moment to express my personal thanks and gratitude to those here in attendance today. Susan Golding, fortunately she was not able to attend, but thank you, Susan. Ted Butch, Brian Keeney, Chris Hewitt, Paul Zwicky, and Dave Peltz. Many of you may not know this, but the road to this point was paved by a small group of individuals and was formed initially as an association known as YSAT. This group was led by gentlemen Fred Krueger and Susan Golding, and their charter was to try to find a solution to meet the growing field needs of our community's youth sports leagues. This group was instrumental in beginning and starting the dialogue that ultimately led to the Antenna Farm Project. And while that project was promising at first, after some very public debate, it was determined that that site would not fulfill the intended destiny for our children. In 2007, Tracy Little League, in concert with several of the other leagues, lobbied our city council to annex the Holly Sugar Fields and provide us with a start, a base upon which we could build our fields. Our city leaders listened to us, they accepted the challenge, and they made the investment to this goal and made it attainable for us. And today, Tracy Little League takes our first step in meeting and keeping our promise that we made to the city of Tracy and its citizens.
Thank you.
When we were first introduced to the various names that the city was considering to name this park, we were very excited and drawn to Legacy Fields. We again lobbied the city to adopt this name. Why do we think this is so important? Well, legacy by definition is anything handed down from the past as from an ancestor or predecessor. We can't think of a better brand or image that describes how our city has historically risen to challenges and has overcome obstacles to get our fields built. We view our new home here at Legacy Fields as the continued legacy of many of the founding families here in Tracy. New members of our corporate community and future generations continuing the actions of our predecessors. So while we're speaking of some of these predecessors, I want to take this opportunity to recognize a few of the families that were very instrumental in building our previous home at Jefferson. Families such as the Anyas, the Gollies, the Eversons, the Pikuses, and the Weatheralls. I probably failed to mention a few, and I apologize for that. You are not forgotten. These founding families were all instrumental in building our fields at Jefferson. And our promise to you today is that your legacy will continue here today at our new home at Legacy Fields. This is our first step in the right direction, not only for our league, but for our community. The model we established is really the only financially responsible and feasible solution for the future of youth sports in our city. Today, we have proven that this can be accomplished and that the model works. We've challenged the City Council to give us the opportunity, and they challenged us to meet the promise. 7 years ago, I told Mayor Ives, just give us some dirt and we'll build the fields. Today, we get to make good on that promise. So what's next? How are we going to build the rest of this project? As you look around, there are a lot of challenges and obstacles that lay ahead. Not just for us, but for the other leagues. But we will overcome and we will prevail. There are today many upstanding members within our community that support the creation of a foundation for Legacy Fields. They will act to raise funds working with our city and the private sector to help guide and support the needs of our youth sports leagues in building their fields. The successful establishment of this foundation will further our effort and ultimately lead to the successful completion of Legacy Fields project. Furthermore, I believe we need to revisit the original design and perhaps repurpose some of the uses to include potential other sports and perhaps create a physical home for a future Tracy Hall of Fame. What's a better location than Legacy Fields to honor our city's past historical sports accomplishments? There is an old proverb, it takes a village to raise a child. Well, our spin on that today is it takes a community to raise Legacy Fields. Thank you. Okay, so now this is it's definitely the most exciting part of our program today. So part of this model has been raising funds, finding a way to get this built. Many within our own Little League community questioned, how are we going to be able to do this? How are we going to be able to raise funds? Certainly many in the community have questioned that. We have been confidently pursuing the effort to show that the model will work, to show that there's support within the community, within the business community, to be able to make this happen. And today, I'm very proud and excited to announce that Tracy Little League has indeed found such a benefactor. And we are pleased today to introduce to you the Sandu brothers and their family, who have graciously agreed to build Tracy Little League A field. So, if I could please ask for a couple of members of the Sandu brothers to.
I'm Manny Sandu, and on behalf of the Sandu family here, I'd just like to say that we're proud to be a part of this community, and any program that helps support this community or benefit this community, we're more than happy to support. So, thank you very much.
So other than the undying gratitude of all of the members of the Little League community, we have a million thanks for you. But to honor your donation, we have a couple of gifts for you today. We have a crystal trophy presented to the Sandu brothers. And inscribed on it, it says, for their generous donation and support of Tracy Little League in the construction of the Akal Field. We have a bat that we would also like to present with a similar inscription. So thank you. Thank you so much from the bottom of our heart.
What an exciting day. It's a great team out here. I did not expect all of you to show up. Council members, mayor, thank you for everything you folks have done. Sandu family as well, thank you very much from the bottom of our hearts. At this time, we're gonna do our groundbreaking ceremony and put some shovels in the dirt. What do you think? Woo! All right. I invite you all to stick around for refreshments and pictures. Otherwise, thank you for supporting Tracy Little League and have a wonderful weekend.